is a dance that they're doing down Maruru way. The surfies and the sandies will make it stay. Feel that rhythm, you can feel that beat. All you gotta do is move your feet and go stomp, stomp, stomp on at Maroubra.
I have before me the person who immortalised stomping at Maroubra. I'm in front of the Maroubra Surf Lifesaving Club where the dance was performed.
And you're going to say, let's have a stomp?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I was more going to say, you have a stomp and I'll watch you.
No. You can stomp. It's really
okay,
easy.
Okay, well, come on.
Okay.
Can you get a stomp?
Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Stomp, 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 stomp on at Maroubra. Stomp, stomp, stomp on at Maroubra. Stomp, stomp, stomp on at Maroubra. Everybody's doing the Maroubra stomp.
But there's nothing so lonesome.
You feel like you're on sacred ground everywhere around here. I mean, this is, you know, a venerable shrine, the whole of EMI Studios. You've returned it to its original purpose.
Well, when I saw it for sale, and I actually thought that it needed to be restored for the reasons that it's been created, and that was to actually make music and not be a smoking lounge for people getting their songs mastered. So, to me, it's so rewarding. As far as the history goes that's been on here, I'm still learning about it. You know, there's so many things that have happened in this whole complex.
Yes.
Even without the technology that they had back then, what it had to prove, or what they proved, was that they were great musicians, because you didn't have the ability to be able to do several different takes of the thing and edit it and comp it and take this bit and put it with that bit, etc. So hats off to those that were doing it, you know, with absolutely no enhancement tools by any means. I mean, and Slim Dusty's clearly one of those guys.
Don Bartley, we're bandying around the term sacred site. Over the years that you've worked here, do you have any particular recollections, reminiscences of sessions or music that was made or things that took place in this studio?
Man, it's amazing. Sometimes you'd sit here and you'd open the door and then you'd see Bob Dylan walking past, and then Elton John would go up there and of course, Bowie was here for 3 months and he became part of the furniture almost, and we were, you know, became sort of, have a cup of tea with David and he would make a tea for you sometimes even. He was here so often. I recently remastered the Slim Dusty Pub With No Beer track, which was recorded here 50 years ago. And I was on my own when I was doing that, and I swear that there was someone walking around enjoying what I was doing. And I was totally on my own, and I had that feeling that somebody was behind me. But it was a nice feeling. It was very friendly. Of that pub with a low beer.